अपना कोर्स, गेट स्मार्ट, गेट अहेड।
वेलकम टू द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ लघु सिद्धांत कौमुदी। सो नाउ इन दिस पार्ट टू वी आर गोइंग टू लुक एट अच संधि। अगेन अच संधि वी हैव स्प्लिट इट इनटू थ्री पार्ट्स, विच इज यण संधि, आयादि संधि एंड गुण संधि। Now, where and when is sandhi required? So, is there any logic or rule which says that where sandhi has to be applied and where sandhi need not be applied? So, there is a sutra. This is the thumb rule or the golden rule as far as sandhi application is concerned. Samhitaikapade nitya, nitya dhatupasargayoho, nitya samase vakyetu sam vivaksham apekshate. Nitya means where permanent. So, sandhi is always required in the following condition. Samhita. In Samhita, we require the sandhi. What is Samhita? We have seen in the 12th sutra of the Laghu Siddhanta Kaumudi, where it is telling, Paraha Sannikarshaha Samhita. When two alphabets come together, then sandhi is required. So, this is the first one. Samhitaikapade nitya, nityam dhatu pasargayoho. Dhatu, when you are using dhatu, means the verb. Then you are having upasarga. We'll see what is upasarga. Pra, para, apa, sama are some examples of upasarga. So when upasarga and dhatu is being used, you need to have sandhi. Nityam samase, in samasa you require the sandhi. Then where is it optional? When it is in vakyetu, when you are making a sentence. In sentence, when you have got a distance between two alphabets, then sandhi is not mandatory. So the most important is samhita, dhatu, upasarga, samasa. Wherever this is happening, sandhi is mandatory. Now we come to the first sandhi, which is part of the Ach sandhi. So this is the 15th sutra. First 14 sutras we have already seen in the part 1. So as continuing our discussion further, the first thing what we have to do or introspect or dissect a sutra is to find out what is the type of sutra. So Ikayanachi is a typical Vidhi Sutra. Vidhi is operational. We have seen earlier also the six types of sutras. If you have not, please go back and listen to part 1, wherein we have talked about that six types: Vidhi, Niyama, Atidesha, Adhikara and Sanya Sutram. So this is an operational sutra. Now, next job is Padacheda, is to split the sutra before we make any sense. So, ikaha, so visarga has become okaram here. So, one it will become, we will talk about when we talk about visarga sandhi. So, it is actually ikaha, yan and achi. Iko, yan, achi is the padacheda. So, ikasthane yan syad achi samhitayam vishaye. Is the meaning it gives you. Ikastane yan syat samhitayam vishaye. Now, they have brought in 2-3 words. What are the 2-3 words? Ikaha is already there. Yan is already there. Achi is already there. So, ikaha stane yan Syad Achi Samhitayam Vishaye. So we also looked again in part 1. Sutreshu Adrishtam Padam. This has to be by-hearted by you. This is a very, very, very important golden rule. Sutreshu Adrishtam Padam Sutrantarad Anuvartaniyam Sarvatra. So Samhitayam. So if you look at it, this is your Panini's Ashtadhyayi, chapter 6, 1. Where I am taking from 72nd Sutra to the 77th Sutra. You have already seen this. which tells you. So ikah yan achi is the sutra number 77. So it is predecessor. Sutreshu adrishtam pradam samhitayam is one single sutra. So 6172 is only samhitayam. So from that word samhitayam, che cha samhitayam, angmangos cha samhitayam, dirgat samhitayam, padantadva samhitayam, iko yanachi samhitayam. This is how the adhikara works of samhitayam, which is an adhikara sutra. So this is an adhikara sutra. So the word samhitayam is inherited. What we call it in technology and things like that, we call about inheritance. So the word samhitayam is inherited. It goes on further till other sutras. For your current understanding, samhitayam is the adhikara sutra based on which ikko yanachi, the word samhitayam, is brought in. So sutreshu adrishtam padam sutrantarad anuvartaniyam sarvatra iti karanena samhitayam comes here. Now what is ik? So ik is e u r l, then yan y v r l, then achi is entire vowels. So ikah is again repeating. Again, if you go back to this pratyahara, this is one of the 42 or 44 pratyaharas which you have seen. Ik stands for e u r l k. K is again it, halantyam, tasya lopah, adirantyena saha ita. These are the three sutras. The moment you talk about any pratyahara, three sutras should come to the back of your mind. First is halantyam. Second is tasya lopah, halantyam gets lopa. The third is adirantyena saha ita. The purpose of having this it is for the purpose of making a pratyahara. So this is the code word used by Panini. Ik automatically means e u r l. Yan means y v r l. Again, I have put halantyam here because again you go back, even though there is an a there, akaradishu akaraha hakaradishu akaraha uchcharanartah. There is one more reading there. Based on that, it is y v r l and na. Again, na should have been disappearing. Na is again it here. Yan. Then you have got achi. So a, e, u, r, l, a, o, I, au, cha. So this is again it. So this is what is meant by. So ik means four characters. Yan means four characters. Ach means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And it includes all vowels. So now I have put some number on top. This you need to start understanding. So the entire Sanskrit works on what is called as Vibhakti Pratyayam. We already saw in the earlier one what is called Subantam. Subantam. Su aujas, am aujastha, byambyas, nge byambyas, like that we saw as one of the Supting Antam Padam. So in that we have seen there are seven Vibhakti Pratyayas in Sanskrit. So the first one is what is called as Prathama. Shashti, this is 6, means this is Shashti Vibhakti. Then Achi is called Saptami Vibhakti. So I have given a superscript for you to understand it in the right manner, so that this will also help you in understanding Sanskrit grammar. So anything and everything you take, first thing is you have to look at the Vibhakti Pratyayam. So Ikah means what? Of Ik, that is Shashti Vibhakti as I said, or in place of Ik. Yan is Prathama. Achi is Saptami, or what is also called Sati Saptami, means conditional. So Sati Saptami means conditional. So when Ach follows, so of Ik there will be Yan when Ach follows. So three conditions, we will see that as we go along. So the example he has given is Sudhi Upasya as an example. Now I decompose the entire Sudhi Upasya into the lowest level, like whatever you call it as molecule or atom, like your physics and chemistry. Here you have to also, if you're good at chemistry and physics, you will understand this. This is like the formula. Very exactly like the formula. Here we have to decompose Sudhi Upasya as below. It is Sa, which is Halantam, followed by U, Ukarantam. Then you have got Dha, then you have got Dirga E, then you have got U, then you have got Pa Halantyam, then you have got A, and then you have got Sa, and then you have got Ya. Now, what does Sudhi Upasya say? Ikastane, now we have got Ikast Yan Achi. In place of Ik, there will be Yan. Now, I have used some color codes and used technology to make you understand. First, let us see which are the Iks in the system. So, Ika and Yan. Ik will become Yan when Ach follows. So, how many Iks are there? There is a scenario here. U is an Ik. If you look at E, U, R, L, K is an Ik. Therefore, it is marked as blue. Then you have got E, which also can be an Ik. So, I have already marked in the second scenario. And this E is also what is called as Ach. So, first you should have E, your Ik. Then you should have Ach. Then what happens? It will become Yan. So, let us look at the group first. Before you go into Yan, let us look at the group of where Ik and Ach is there together. So, one scenario is this. So, you have got Ik, you have got Ach. Again, you can treat this as Ik and then you can treat this as Ach. Again, this can be treated as Ik and this is Ach. So, now I am going to confuse you. Which of these Iks will become Yan when Ach follows? You have got two things. So, scenario one is you have got whether this U will go and become, or this E will go and become, or this U will go, or this A will go. There is no clarity. So, which of the two scenarios is correct? We need to look at it. Why? Because Samhitayam. So, the next point comes is Samhitayam. What is Samhita? We already seen. Samhitayam Vishaye Param Sannikarshaha Samhita. So, here Ik and Ach should come together. Then only. So, here it will not be applicable because there is no Samhita. There is an Hal in between. So, here there is a Samhita. Here there is no Samhita because there is an Ach Hal in between. The Samhita means your E and A should come next to each other. So, there is a Samhita here. So, this is only the correct one where we can apply this grammar rule. Because the key word there is Samhita. So, first Ik followed by Ach. When it happens, then it will become Yan. Now, there is absolute confusion. Whether Ik will become Yan or Ach will become Yan. It is only telling Iko Yan Achi. Of Ik, when Ach follows, there will be Yan. So, what is the confusion? Whether Ik will go or Ach will go. Which of the two will go? Ach will go or Ik will go? We do not know. So, what we have to see now? Tasmin iti nirdishte purvasya is the next sutra which we have to look at. So, what does it say? This is again a typical example of your Tasmin iti nirdishte purvasya is again a paribhasha sutram. So, what it is telling is saptami nirdishte nirdeshena vidiyamanam karyam varnantarena avyavahitasya purvasya bodhyam. Now, we will take this. This is a bit long. Saptami nirdeshena. So, that is why I put this as a superscript. That which is ordained by a saptami vibhakti, the change will happen to the former alphabet is what is a simple meaning. So it's a paribhasha sutram. The change will happen to the alphabet immediately preceding that which is said in Saptami Vibhakti. So here what is said in Saptami Vibhakti is Ach. So the change will not happen to Ach, the change will happen to Ik. So that settles your question of Ik will go and or Ach will go. So change will happen to Ik. So this is established. Change will not happen to Ach. The change will happen only to this Ik and not the earlier Ik, because this is not a Samhita which we have already discussed. So E goes and will be now replaced by Yavarlana. So N means we have passed the code word Yavarlana. Now the next question or the next confusion. E will become Y or E will become V or E will become R or E will become L. So because it is telling 1 is to 4. It is only telling that E will go and it will be replaced by Yavarlana. You are not sure what is going to come in place of E. Now again we have to look forward to Tupanidin to give us a solution. Let us look at the solution which is given there. Is Sthane Antaratamaha. That is the next sutra. So if you remember what is Sthanam, we have discussed Sthanam in depth. When we discussed Tulyasya Prayatnam Savarnam Vachyam. So when we discussed Tulyasya Prayatnam Savarnam Vachyam, there we had discussed this description or explanation. Prasangi Sati Sadrishadamaha Adeshaha Syat is the description for Sthani Antaratamaha. What does it tell? In the context, what is getting replaced? So Adeshaha is what is called as replaced. Sthani ani adeshaha. This is called sthani. That which is getting kicked off or replaced is called sthani. Then adeshaha is what is getting replaced. Substitute. Adeshaha is the substitute and sthani is which is getting out or replaced. So what is replaced is called sthani and it is substituted by what is called? It is called adeshaha. So what is the adeshaha here? The Adeshaha, we have got Ya, Va, Ra and La. And if you have got one-to-many relationship, you need to eliminate. You cannot have all the four there. You need to eliminate. And how am I eliminating it? By a sutra called Sthane Antaramatamaha, which tells which is the most proximity in terms of Sthanam. So we have seen Sthanam in Tulyasya Prayatnam, Savarnam. We had discussed about Sthanam and Prayatnam. So in this context, it is telling you look at the sthanam. So now let us look at the sthanam. Ichu yashanam talu. So E is talu. Ya is talu. Then vakarasya dantoshtam. Somewhere we saw. Ruturashan lutusanam dantaha. Yamangananam nasika vodha. Vakarasya dantoshtam. So V is nothing but dantoshtam. Ruturashanam murda. And then Raturashanam Murda. Dan Danta Latulasanam Dantaha. So when you have got E which has to be replaced by Ya, Va, Ra, La, the most proximate from Sthanam is Thalu. So logically E will become Ya. So Su, A, Dha, Ya. E goes away and Ya comes in.
Apna course. Get smart. Get ahead.